Hello children. Hi. So, welcome back to our next lecture. That is lecture number 5, Nationalism in India, the Rowlatt Act 1919. Children, last time where we stopped the three successful expeditions of Gandhiji, we are going to continue from there as per your NCERT chapter. This period 1919 is very important from the Indian history point of view for two reasons. One being World War I came to an end in 1918 and all Indians were very enthusiastic, very happy and with lot of hopes and aspirations, thinking that whatever promises that were made by the British government before World War I will be fulfilled by the British government. Hence, jubilations, like, you know, we are going to get so many things now. But all their hopes and aspirations, whatever their dreams were ruined. Why? Because of this act, Rowlatt Act of 1919. Now, what does the Rowlatt Act of 1919 say? The causes. Now, I feel the font being a bit small, you won't be able to read it properly. But let me explain you. Increased dissatisfaction after World War I. See, the Britishers, children, were never in a mood to fulfill the promises what they had made to the Indians. They always, you know, followed the policy of, you know, making false promises and then lingering about the things, lingering about postponing, keeping it in pipeline. So, when the time came for them to fulfill the promises, at that point of time, they should have just postponed things. So here, what happened when they were postponing the things, at that point of time, dissatisfaction amongst the Indian masses grew and people were talking here and there, "Are, when they are going to fulfill the promises, oh, when is the day going to come, how long we are supposed to wait, it's high time, blah, blah, blah." Now, and after that, the Montague Declaration, Montague comes for reforms, if you remember, we did it in class 8th also. Yes. So, that showed no immediate, you know, steps to be taken by the government to provide home rule. Then, British government was concerned they would not be able to control the population. Hence, they passed this act called as the Rowlatt Act of 1919. Now, what action could be taken under this act? It gave the government enormous power, okay, to catch hold of the suspects who spoke against the British government and send them to jail without taking them before the court of law. The normal procedure is that if a crime takes place, the police catches hold of the concerned person, of the suspect, and then that person is put before the court of law. There, the hearing is done. After that, the punishment or rescue is done. But here, according to this Rowlatt Act, they said, the act said that if anybody is found either speaking or holding meetings or writing anything or taking rallies against the, you know, British government, demonstrations, whatever, slogans, nobody will be spared. That person will be put behind the bars for 2 years. I hope Rowlatt Act is clear now. Now, and censorship had increased, means you cannot print anything against the law. Then you cannot move outside, you know, like what we are having curfew, a strict, we are not moving outside the house. Right? So something similar type, that more people, you know, more than 4 to 5 people cannot move outside, cannot walk outside, cannot make a group, talk, chit chat and so on. But when this act came, now how did the Indian Indians respond to this act of 1919? Just think. One hand, one side, all hopes and aspirations, right? The people are thinking, wow, World War I over, England is now won the war, and what is going to happen? Our promises are going to be fulfilled, isn't it? On the other hand, what is happening? They come with a very harsh act called as the Act of 1919. Now, whereby it says that nobody is going to speak against the government, and whatever has been given to you as per the Montague claims for, you have to keep yourself satisfied. That is what we can give you. Remaining, we will think in. Now, the Congress under the leadership of Gandhiji, no doubt. Okay, now they were not in a mood to listen to this. Hence, there were rallies, there were strikes. Okay, and people in their own way were trying to oppose this Rowlatt Act. I hope you can imagine. This again gives you a picture of, you know, what the Rowlatt Act was. And you know, this most of the protesters, they came from Punjab. Why? Because the people who participated wholeheartedly were from Punjab in World War I. So naturally, more bloodshed from there. So you know, it pinches you. Now, how was the Rowlatt Act opposed? Rallies were organized in various cities. Workers went on strike in railway workshops, and shops were closed down. Now, just look at this picture. Anything you are getting? This? This bullet mark? Right. So this is Jallianwala Bagh massacre. Okay? Now, what is Jallianwala Bagh massacre and how is it related to Rowlatt Act? The question in your annual exam comes, either write a short note on Rowlatt Act, where you have to write why it happened, what were the reaction of the Indians, how did the British suppress it, this is one question, or write a short note on the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. So these bullet marks which you see is of Jallianwala Bagh, they are still there. It's a memorial right now. This is the wall where people had jumped to escape the bullets. The people who had gathered over there, you know very well, we had run it already in class 8, still I'll tell you, we'll have a recapitulation of it. But just, you know, just a revision, see the dead bodies lying? Okay. Now, what happened? Now, in this, actually what happened, there were Baisakhi festival, and in this Baisakhi festival what had happened was that people, you know, they gathered fair, people gathered together to celebrate Mela, which you call, and it's a huge ground in Amritsar, and it had only one entry and one exit. So people had gathered over there to celebrate, though this Rowlatt Act was, had been passed. Now, General Dyer, he comes inside along with his troops, and without even informing the people that they are supposed to leave or vacate the place, he gives the order for shootout, as a result of which hundreds of people died and many hundreds were wounded. So this is associated with your Rowlatt Act. 2 days earlier, when the Rowlatt Act, people came to know about the Rowlatt Act in Punjab itself, there were a lot of strikes, hartals, demonstrations, rallies going on, you know, protesting. So this General Dyer was given the responsibility to control the situation. So he controlled it in the swing. This is the way he controlled, though he was criticized for his act by the British government later on. But then, you know, crime is a crime. How can you justify that? So, in the afternoon of April 13, a crowd of at least 10,000 men, women and children that gathered in the Jallianwala, which was nearly completely enclosed by walls. I told you earlier also, one entry, one exit, and the soldiers are just encircling them, and this man from behind giving the order, shoot. And you know, they just, and these Indians, like, you know, if you remember the beginning of the lecture, I told you that Gandhiji said Indians were being ruled by the Britishers for such a long time. Why? Because the Indians were cooperating with them. Children, person to give order was General Dyer, right? An Englishman. But the people who are shooting are all Indians. Didn't they have mercy in their heart? So if we blame Dyer, we are supposed to blame those Indians also. That why didn't they say no to General Dyer's instruction? Aren't they also defaulters? Thing to be thought about. Okay, estimated 379 people were killed in this. This includes women, children, men, old, young, everything. And 1200 more were wounded. And people, you know, the wall that surrounded that ground was a bit high, a huge one. So people were trying to climb that wall and get to the other side, or, you know, even there's a well over there, which I showed you in the picture. They tried to jump into the well. It is said that the water of that well was bloody for many years later on, many days, many years later on. Now, what were the reactions? How did the masses react? How did the Congress react? The shooting was followed by the proclamation of martial law in Punjab. Martial law means that, you know, you cannot move outside, shoot at sight, all these things are there. Then, when the news reached to the other part of the country, people started giving back their titles. And Gandhiji's thinking what to do, what step, what concrete should be done so that we can teach the Britishers a lesson, we can tell them that what you have done is wrong. Anyway, this is, I hope you can read it, Khilafat movement. Okay. Khilafat movement and non-cooperation movement. Now, you can see in this picture, Gandhiji is surrounded. See, this is, Sarojini Naidu. Then this is Sarat Khan. That is, he became a Pakistani after, you know, partition. Gandhiji, Nandiani brothers. Now this is another question when it comes. This is another topic, Khilafat movement. See, this question can come. And this way, like, how is the Khilafat movement associated with Jallianwala Bagh massacre? Okay? Or you can, you know, Khilafat movement and Jallianwala Bagh massacre are closely interlinked, justify, explain in different way, because both of them have a linkage. Let's see how. Now, during World War I, Turkey was defeated by England. Turkey is an Islamic state, still is an Islamic state, that time also it was, and it was defeated. Now the head of Turkey was Palace Khalifa, who happens to be the religious head of the Muslims. Okay, like we have Guru Shankaracharya, Hindus have so many gurus. We have Shankaracharya, we have their mutt, feet, everything. So this Islamic guru, the Khalifa of all the Muslims, since Turkey was defeated and England won over there, so, you know, they took over Turkey and denied to give the rights to the Khalifa, his respectable position. Because see, in war, you are either a winner or the loser. You may be whatever in your country, but once you have lost the war, that means you've lost. Simple. then why should the opponent, why do you expect an opponent giving you a respectable position? But no. Since he was a religious head also, so this hurt the religious sentiments of the Muslims in India. Okay, I hope you got my point. Now, what did these Muslims want? Two brothers, Muhammad Ali and Shaukat Ali, they came ahead with a proposal to Gandhiji that they wanted to stand against the British government, to start a movement against the British government, a nationwide movement, whereby if they succeed, they could get the lost position of the Turk, I mean that Ottoman Turk, and the territories to be given back to that Khalifa, and his position, whatever he enjoyed, should be given back. Why? Because he was the religious head. Those were the arguments. We feel it foolish this time, but okay, those were the arguments those days. Chaliye. Coming back, so these Ali brothers who initiated the movement came to Gandhiji asking him that could they start a movement whereby, you know, they could pressurize the British government to do something for the Khalifa. Now, Gandhi saw an opportunity in this. He thought, otherwise the Muslims and the Hindus, you know, Muslim League and the Hindus, they all are separately, you know, struggling for independence. This is an opportunity to bring them together, shake hands and work for a common cause. Let the Congress do it for Jallianwala Bagh and let them do for Turkey. But, you know, by doing so, the Hindus and Muslims are coming together and working. So, by this way, at least you can get unity between the Hindus and the Muslims. Now, what was the program of non-cooperation? The program of non-cooperation was, it began with surrender of titles that the government awarded. You know, those sometimes used to give titles, Raja Sahab, then Sahab Bahadur, okay, then Sir, the title of Sir was also conferred. Those who were loyal to the Britishers. So those people who had got these titles, Gandhiji said you give back the titles to them. Like these days also, you know, all those who are against the BJP government are giving back the titles. Okay, it is their work opposite. So, then withdrawing children from government schools, colleges, you know, not going to the courts, English courts, and the boycott, not buying the British goods. This was the program of non-cooperation. But before the program to be implemented, the Congress, some of the members of the Congress, no doubt, did not want to participate in the non-cooperation movement. Reason behind, they wanted to participate in the council elections of 1920. And hence they did not want to, you know, lose that opportunity. So they were not in a mood. It took time to Gandhiji to bring them to a consensus, saying that this will work out. Now the reason behind is that these people, they knew very well that Gandhiji would emphasize on non-violence, and it will be difficult for the people to, you know, keep their temperature down in the thermometer and not go to any violent act. And if the people go on a violent act, he is going to take back the movement, and take back the movement means the council elections are affected. So they did not want that to happen. They were not in a mood, but anyway, Congress session took place in December 1920 in Nagpur, whereby they thought, they deliberated, they discussed over the different issues, and then they reached a common understanding that a non-cooperation movement should be started in the country. Okay. Now in this particular slide, What were the objectives of Gandhiji to join Khilafat movement? When was the Khilafat Day observed in India? What were the objectives of Khilafat movement? These are the generally, you know, type of questions that come in the exam. And these are the, this is the answer. See, this is the 3-mark question. This is the 1 mark. Again, this is 1 mark. So, you know, these type of questions occur. Again, important questions. So, these are important questions. Write a short note on Rowlatt Act. Describe the Jallianwala Bagh tragedy. Why was the Khilafat committee formed? What did they demand? Why did Gandhiji support the Khilafat movement? I hope, children, you have understood this. Now, in the next lecture, we will be doing about, once the non-cooperation movement is launched, then how did people interpret that movement? How did the movement, you know, carry forward? What was the progress? Was it a success or a failure? Till then, bye. Take good care of yourself. Eat healthy. Stay healthy. Thank you.